Was the first time you were champion, was that from the Money in the Bank match that we had that you won and then went on to cash it in? Was that the first time you were the champion?
First time, and that I remember the Money in the Bank I didn't want anything to do with.
That's right.
Yeah,
I remember that the first, this was for a WrestleMania, I believe it was 20, and the idea that they had was Jericho versus Edge versus Benoit in a three-way submission match.
And I don't have a submission.
Yes, you don't have a submission. And also, how the hell would you do that? Like a three-way? It just reeked of like, we've got nothing for these guys to do, so why don't we just put them together? And then there was a couple other guys that didn't have anything else to do, and I think it was Gewurz and I that came up with the initial idea. And I remember either he told you about it or I did, and you didn't want to do it. You didn't like the idea. I don't want to do another ladder match or whatever it was.
Yeah, I was like, I don't want to be in a ladder match. Just don't put me in it. And I remember going as far as saying, don't put me on Mania. I'll get back to it. I'll make sure that I'm on it next year, but if that's what you got, don't put me in it. And I remember like you and Glenn and Kane and Chris and Jay like kind of saying, oh, this could be cool. And it really took some, it was one of those instances where I was so far off the mark.
Well, I mean, I remember even, I don't know if I ever actually said it, but thinking to myself, like, you know, shut up, dummy, you're gonna win this thing, just be quiet, you know? But I mean, that's, and then we, like you said, it's funny, because I was talking to Steve Austin about this a couple weeks ago. You felt it, I felt it. Sometimes when you get so, I don't even know what the word is, but you can't see the forest through the trees sometimes. I'm the same. I mean, when you get an idea in your head, it's like, I will be the most stubborn son of a bitch ever. I don't care. Like you said, take me off. I'm done.
And it's from a point of caring, or maybe caring too much in a way, too. It's like you not being able to kind of separate yourself from seeing what could be this opportunity and this amazing thing because it wasn't your idea.
Right.
Or because you didn't think of it, or because, like, I don't get it because it wasn't my idea. I don't even understand this.
I remember you and I at SummerSlam when we had the 7-on-7 with the NXT, with Nexus. It was WWE team versus Team Nexus. And the finish, it was an elimination tag, and the finish boiled down to you and me were in there, but it was Cena against a couple of them, and John wanted to do things a certain way, and we told him, you're wrong. Remember that? And he did it anyways, and it sucked. And then afterwards, he came over to us and said, I should have listened to you, but I wasn't seeing it that way. And sometimes you just don't see it that way, you know?
One of those things, and sometimes you need to catch the bed in order to go, oh.
Yes, exactly.
And that was one of those deals where he was adamant to what he wanted to do, and I remember I was like, fine, I'm out of the match by that point.
Yeah, exactly. He wanted to DDT, get DDT'd on the floor by Barrett, then kick out, and then beat them both. And you and I were like, that's the dumbest thing. Like, that's just throwing it away for no reason. And anyways.
Well, when I thought they should have gone over because they were so high.
I remember we were fighting for Barrett to go over. I agree. And all in all fairness, where's Wade Barrett now? They should have listened to us, you know?
Yeah, that was one of those instances where I think we're actually right, you know, and I think there was a lot of those, but that was one especially where I was like, oh, and I really did. I just went, I'm gone by that point. Fine, do what you got to do.